I am narrating the presentation for the course Management, course code 22509. Unit Outcome 1, explain the purpose of the Industrial Legislative Acts. Dear student, in this presentation, we are going to learn the purpose of the Industrial Legislative Act. Objectives: remember a clear definition of the labor laws. Know the thrust areas of the labor laws. Understand the categorization of different labor laws like Industrial Dispute Act, Factory Act, Workmen Compensation Act, Minimum Wages Act, etc. And understand the basic objectives and necessity of the labor laws. Introduction. Industrial laws are framed by the government to provide economic and social justice to the worker in the industries. Previously, there was a lot of exploitation of the worker by the employer. Then the worker struggled very hard, then government come to know and frame the laws for social and economical justice of the workers. Generally, these laws provide a guideline for wages, wages incentive, bonus, overtime, working condition like temperature, humidity, purity of air, motion of air, light, ventilations, facilities for the worker like drinking water facilities, transportation facilities, canteen facilities, fair distribution of the profit, that is, if some of the profit is earned by the organization, some of the profit should be shared with the worker because workers struggle very hard and that's why the industries are getting more and more profit. And providing protection to the worker against the harmful accident, though the industries are taking lot of protection or precautions to avoid the accident, but if some of the accident occurs, then these laws provide a protection to the workers against the accidents. Principles of industrial legislation. There are four principles like social justice, social welfare, national economy, and international uniformity. Principles of industrial legislation. First is a social principle or social justice. These laws help the worker by ensuring suitable distribution of the profit and benefit. In the previous slide also, we have learned that if some of the profit is shared with the worker, then the worker will be satisfied and they will work very hard to improve the efficiency of the organization. It provides a better working condition. If the working conditions are better, then the workers are satisfied with the work. Again, the efficiency of the industry will be increased. Social welfare. These laws help to improve the social status of the worker by providing adequate wages, more than the minimum wages, safety measure, that is accident-free industry, ensuring appropriate working hours. The working hours should not be too long, so that there may be the chances of accidents, and health facilities like a dedicated doctor, dedicated medical center, ambulance facilities, etc. National economy. If these laws are implemented properly, then the worker will be satisfied. The worker will work more hard. Hence, the earning of the industry will be increases. And finally, it improves the national economy. International uniformity. All the laws throughout the world in every country is same. So immigration of the worker from the one nation to the another nation is made very easy. Thrust areas of the labor laws. Safety and health and welfare of the labor. Social security of the labor. Policy relating to the special target group such as women and child labor. Industrial relationship. There should be harmonious relationship between the employee and the employee, or employee and the employer, and there should not be any disputes. If there is any dispute occur in the industry, then the dispute should be solved in the industry itself, or they can take the help of the industrial tribunals or labor courts. Thrust areas of the labor laws. First is the workers' education and training. The technology is continuously changing, so skill of the worker should be enhanced. So that's why there is a workers' education and training is compulsory for every industry. Labor and employment statistics, it is required by the central and state government to know how much laborers are working in an organized sector, how much workers are working in an unorganized sector. Immigration of labor for the employment abroad. Employment services and occupational training. There is an employment services board formed by the central government. The unemployed diploma holder, degree holder and ITI holder can register with the employment services board. And if any industry are requiring a people, then they can call them from the employment service board. Occupational training. The Apprentice Act is there in the India. And this Apprentice Act is compulsory for every industry. Under this Apprentice Act, the 1 year training is compulsory for degree holder, diploma holder and ITI holder. Labor laws. Laws relating to the industrial relationship. There should be a harmonial relationship between the employee and the employee or employer and the employee. Laws related to the wages, that is a Minimum Wages Act. Law related to the working hours, working condition and services condition. It comes under the Factory Act 1948. Laws relating to the equality and empowerment of the woman. Again, it comes under the Act of Factory Act 1948. Prohibitive labor laws. The worker should not be work under the alcoholic condition or the condition like he has taken the drugs. And laws related to the employment and the training. Necessity of the legislative acts to improve the industrial relationship between the employee and the employee or the employee and the employer. They help in paying the minimum wages to the workers. For this, there is a Minimum Wages Act. Minimize the unrest among the workers. So there is a Industrial Dispute Act. Provide compensation to the worker or the dependent of the worker if there is any accident with the worker. So there is the Workmen Compensation Act. They help in reducing the conflict and strikes, so for which there is a Industrial Dispute Act. They provide job security for the worker, so it comes under the Factory Act. And promote the wholesome environmental condition in the industry. So these all acts improve the industrial condition or environmental condition in the industry for the benefit of the industry, for increase the earning of the industry and to increase the earning of the workers. They help in fixing hours of work, rest and pauses. There should not be too long working hours so that the worker will be under stress and there might be a chances of accident. There should be some rest between the work, some pauses should be there, some allowances should be there, so that the worker should be recovered from the stress and the fatigue. Conclusions. Initially, there was a lot of exploitation of the worker by the employer. Then workers struggled very hard for the better condition of the work. Then government come to know and they frame the laws for the better condition of work as well as security of their job. Labor laws protect and safeguard the interest of worker in general and for the deprived and disadvantaged section of the society. Labor laws have now acquired the status of separate branch of law and there are separate certificate courses, degree courses, diploma courses or postgraduate diploma courses in labor laws and the legislation. Therefore, an idea about the concept, law, thrust areas, objectives and classification will be immense help to understand its principle. Thank you.